Romans 8 and 7 says, because the carnal mind is enmity against God, for it is not subject to the law of God, neither indeed can be. To God be the glory.
Thank you. Thank you, Lord Jesus.
That's what it's all about. Amen. Again, we're being met. Hallelujah, Jesus. Thank you, praise team, for that wonderful selection. Amen. We thank God for you. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. We're going to have our invitation by Deacon Harry Rayford at this time. Let's thank God for Deacon Rayford.
Amen. Excuse me, I'm going to say this morning. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Praise God. Amen. We're coming in eternal God. We come this morning with thanksgiving in our heart.
Yes,
we come here saying thank you.
Thank you, Lord.
Father, we thank you for your grace and mercy.
Yes.
We thank you for your love.
Yes.
We thank you for just being who you are.
Yes.
Father, bless everyone right now, Father. Bless those who are the sound of my weak voice this morning, O Heavenly Father. Father, we pray that you would just bless the sick this morning.
Yes.
Bless the bereaved families, O Heavenly Father. Bless those who don't know their way. Father, we pray, thank you for keeping us in our right mind. Oh, Father, we pray that you bless the sick, those who are in the hospital, those who are in the nursing home, and those who are in their own home.
Yes.
Father, keep us and lead us and guide us, Heavenly Father.
Yes, Lord.
Father, you know what we need, Father.
Yes.
Father, we know you say you'll be a doctor in a sick room.
Yes.
You'll be a lawyer in a courtroom.
Yes.
Father, you'll be what we need you to be, Father.
Yes.
Oh, Father, we know we live in some precious time, O Heavenly Father.
Yes.
Father, we want you to just come and be with us this morning.
Yes.
Father, bless the one who's going to speak this morning.
Yes.
Bless his family, O Heavenly Father.
Yes.
Oh, Father, just keep him right now, Father.
Yes.
Father, bless this church, O Heavenly Father.
Yes.
Bless his leaders.
Yes.
Bless his deacons, O Heavenly Father.
Yes.
Bless the congregation, O Heavenly Father. Yes. Father, just bless them, Heavenly Father, wherever they need a blessing.
Yes.
Oh, Father, just keep us. Father, we pray that you will bless this country, O Heavenly Father.
Yes.
Bless the state leaders, O Heavenly Father.
Yes.
The national leaders and the world leaders, Father.
Yes.
Let them think about being the one you are, O Heavenly Father.
Yes.
Let them make the right decision
yes.
to keep this world in peace, O Heavenly Father.
Yes.
Father, we pray that you just keep us, O Heavenly Father.
Yes, yes.
Lead us. Don't let us go astray, Father.
Yes.
There's so much going on.
Oh, yes.
Father, when we're through singing and praising all your songs, O Heavenly Father,
yes.
we pray that you will give us a home somewhere in your home.
Yes.
Well, Christ's sake, amen.
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 Amen. Amen. Amen. Thank you, amen. Amen. Now our scripture will be coming from Minister Casey Carter.
Amen.
Amen. Let's thank God for it.
Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
Good morning.
1 Corinthians 15-58.
Read.
Therefore, my brothers and sisters, stand firm.
Mm-hmm.
Let nothing move you. Always give yourselves fully to the work of the Lord, because you know that your labor in the Lord is not in vain.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
Thank you, my brother. Praise God for you. Amen. And now we will go. Want everybody to join in with us on this opening hymn. Amen. What a fellowship. Amen.
Yeah.
Amen.
This is the day that the Lord has made. Let us all rejoice and be glad in
it.
Amen. Given unto our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, Elder Holmes, our pulpit guest, our speaker of the hour, and each and every one of you that make up our congregation this morning, we would like to welcome each and every one of you to our Men's Day celebration. Absent members, family, and friends can listen to the morning worship service during conference call every Sunday morning at 10 o'clock a.m. Please share with others and simply dial 1-848-777-1212. The access code is 31601. We continue to encourage all members and friends to attend Sunday school at 9 o'clock a.m. and Bible study on Wednesdays at 6 o'clock p.m. Please make plans to attend. Let's study the Word of God together. New Zion will celebrate Easter next Sunday, March 31st, during our morning worship service at 10 a.m. Everyone is welcome to attend. Happy birthday and anniversary for our March celebrants, Brother Travoris Belcher on the 2nd, Sister Diane Berrien on the 14th, Sister Sharon Corte on the 15th, Kanaya Thompson on the 24th, which is today, and Brother Russell Baker Sr. on the 26th. Happy birthday to all of our birthday celebrants. Happy anniversary. Congratulations goes to Brother Travoris Belcher and Sister Chantrell Belcher, who will be celebrating their anniversary on the 25th, which is tomorrow. May God continue to keep you happy and bless you both. Happy anniversary. In our thoughts and prayers, let's continue to keep Sister Sunna Nunn, Sister Daisy Crawford, Brother James Jones, Sister Catherine Belcher, Brother Bob Jackson, Sister Verna Rockingham. Let's continue to pray for each and every one of them on our thoughts and prayers list. God loves you, and so do we. If your name was omitted, please accept our apology, and please make sure to notify the secretary of your birthday or anniversary. Our thought for the week, may the spirit of this Sunday fill your home with peace and blessings.
Yeah.
Thank you, and I hope you all have a wonderful and blessed week.
Amen. Thank you, Sister Jones. Amen for those wonderful announcements today. At this time, our praise team is going to give us another selection. Let's thank God for our praise team. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Ain't no point in crying out like,
I'm Dear God, Heavenly Father, we thank you for those who have come this morning, Father God, to lift up your name.
Yes, yes.
Father God, we come and thank you for those who have a desire to give to you this morning, Father God. We pray that this offering be blessed this morning, Father God. We thank you for the givers. In your Son Jesus' name we pray, amen.
Amen. Amen.
Thank you. Amen. At this time, amen. So that she may come to our offense, we normally do. We don't ask that we please make them understand that we pray for our families. Amen. We pray for our loved ones. Amen. The one that didn't come as home. But we ask you to stand this time as we do our own prayer. Thank you. Hallelujah.
By me, the Lord.
I know. Lord, he's been Methodists and some Holy Ghost filled people. And amen, when we went to church, we had church. Amen, it wasn't no 1 hour, amen. Sometimes it was 6-7 hours, amen. Them folks didn't know how to leave church. Amen, but now as I grow up, amen, I understand why they was praising the Lord. And serving the Lord the way they did.
Yeah.
But so many times we have too much time on our hands to let the enemy just play with us and mess with us. Amen. And just idle mind is a devil workshop. But introducing my speaker for the hour, amen. One of my dear friends, amen, as he comes around us young guys, amen. I call him my mentor. Amen. Every man being he gave it with Pastor Winston, a little stock model. Amen, but I tell you, every tree had to grow from somewhere.
Amen.
Amen. But he's been a dear friend to me, a dear brother. I love him. And when he called me, I had to be here to be with my brother. Amen. Deacon Willie Rafer. But with that introduction, Sunday, March 24, 2024, you can't lead the people if you don't love the people.
Amen. Amen.
You can't love the people if you don't know them. You can't get to know the people unless you walk alongside the people. Our speaker today has definitely walked alongside the people. Deacon Willie Rafer graduated from Pioneerville High in 1964. He earned a bachelor's degree in a science degree in sociology in Savannah State University. He also depended on his knowledge in the gospel, attended seminary, school, college in Atlanta, Georgia. Amen. The speaker is active member of the community, active for social justice in Valdosta, Georgia. He's a member of the Martin Luther King, amen, committee. He is a champion education. He has served the Valdosta City School Board Education in 1986 to ensure that the black and brown scholars receive same resources as their counterparts.
Amen.
Deacon Rafer was elected to Valdosta City Council, where he served 1990 to 1999. Your speaker of the next hour is an instrument of establishing our civil organizations, such as the Black Community Activist Group, the 100 Black Men of Valdosta. Deacon Willie Rafer proudly sports the color black and gold as he faithful member of the Alpha fraternity. Deacon Rafer, he's a devoted member of Morningstar Baptist Church, in which he serves various capitals, such as members of Deacon Rafer Board, Sunday School teacher, and a former superintendent. Deacon Rafer has been married to his wife, Patricia, for 53 years.
Amen.
He is a father of two amazing daughters, Kim Davis and Christy Johnson, for they have four grandchildren. In my pleasure to welcome our speaker of the hour, none other than the haberdasher that we call him ourselves.
Everything that you do, The light of God surrounds me. The love of God enforces me. The power of God protects me. The presence of God watches over me. Wherever I am, God is.
Yes.
Wherever I am,
say that, Ray.
God is.
Yes,
good morning.
Good morning.
I'm so happy to be here this morning. Minister Winston already preached the gospel, so I ain't got too much to do. He already stole my stomach. He already preached. So I'm just so happy to be here this morning. Thank you for inviting me over here today. I see my big brother Harry came all the way from Thomasville to support me. My reason had five boys and seven girls. We all raised up on Holiday Street, and anytime I got in a fight, I would go get my big brother.
Yeah.
You couldn't be all power, so we didn't have to worry about it in Holiday Street. They always protected us. Thank you for being here. I see a lot of people, and I'm going to try to introduce a few people to get on and do what y'all asked me to do.
Amen.
I see J.D. Rice. Raise your hand, J.D. Should have been our first black mayor of our life. Raise your hand, J.D. Councilwoman Santa Tula, Vivian Cody, they're doing a great job. Keep supporting. Don't talk about support. Bring permission to them. Just so happy to be here. Lastly, Earl asked me to get up and speak, and I said, I'll let you know. Mike and Jackson went on Facebook. Just put the wheel away from the name on them. I ain't never agreed to speak. Just put it on there. So I have come all the way back from Atlanta. You know I've been living in Atlanta for the last 3 years, so I'm up here. So if I mess up now, if I do something wrong, Paul Jackie, Michael, not me. You need to stay off of Facebook. I stay in the real book. I'm on. Y'all know me.
Yes, sir.
I'm going to give it to you raw now.
Come on.
Keep it 100.
Yeah, no.
That's a new term they use. I don't know what it means. As you know, I hear around young people all the time. They say keep it 100. So I'm going to try to keep it 100. What does that mean? I don't know. I don't know what it means. What happened to the black man?
Come on.
For about 20 minutes.
Come on.
What happened to the black man? We came over in different ships from Africa.
Yes.
But now we all in the same boat.
Amen.
Yes.
We're in the same boat. We need each other. You ain't got no money, no few pennies. You own no banks. We are number 5 to 1. There are 325 million people in the United States. Only about 50 million black folks. Mm-hmm. So you are number 50 to 1. Mm-hmm. The only thing we got is God and a vote.
Amen.
Got two things going for you. We got God and we got a vote.
Amen.
85% of our people think about themselves. Me, myself, and I.
Mm-hmm.
I got mine and you get yours.
Mm-hmm. Amen.
Get all you can and can't all you get. That's the philosophy of a lot of black folks. That's where we are today. The new Jim Crow is voter suppression. The new Jim Crow is voter suppression. Last year they passed, the white folks passed 375 new laws to keep you from voting. Out of the 47 states, they changed all these new laws to keep you from voting. The white man understands the value of voting. I can remember back in the days when you had to pay a poll tax. If you didn't have any property and the money, you couldn't vote. He led us to test. You had to take it. White man go down there and you read in front of him. He couldn't read, but he assumed that you could read, so he'll let you go. He had a literacy test you had to take back in the day.
Tell it.
Stacey Abram turned Georgia blue.
Come on.
Stacey Abram helped Joe Biden win the presidency.
Yes,
she did. Stacey Abram raised $120 million. Mm-hmm. I don't know where she gets so much money. Ballot office is ranked number 13 out of 535 cities in the state of Georgia. Ballot office is number 13. Stacey Abrams sent some of that money down in the ballot office.
Yes, sir.
I didn't get none of the money.
Yes, sir.
I'm a consultant. I got license to do what I do.
Yes, sir.
I've been doing this for over 50 years. Somebody got some money.
Say it, Ray.
The politicians and the preachers got the money. They ain't giving me none of it. In Atlanta, Georgia, 100,000 people move to Atlanta each year. Put that number now. 100,000 folks come from all across the country, not from Georgia, to live in Atlanta. 100,000 people, most of them black. So what the white people do, they change the laws. They change the laws. You go out voting. For example, they move into polling sites in Atlanta. No, you can't give water in the lines. Purge the books. They take you off the books if you ain't voted in 2 or 3 years and so forth. So that's a way of purging, keeping black folks from voting in Atlanta, Georgia. We don't have that problem here in God also. But moving the dark boxes and so forth. So they have a way of trying to dilute that vote.
Yeah.
Over 100,000 black folks, men, all of them black, 100,000 moved to Atlanta, Georgia. And I don't know why they want to come to Atlanta. But I gave you that number. So you can imagine how the white folks will be, the black people are voting. So they come up with some strategy.
Amen.
Come up with some strategy, always when it comes to voting. In 1966, I met Clarence Thomas in Bobby Hill office in Savannah, Georgia. Clarence Thomas. Clarence Thomas used to work with Bobby Hill. Bobby Hill is one of the smartest black lawyers that I've ever known. He's my friend.
Mm-hmm.
He was tough. Along with Julian Bond. Both of them had some issues. Both of them got in some trouble.
Mm-hmm.
But I love them. But they fought for black folks.
Amen.
Clarence Thomas is Uncle Tom.
Mm-hmm.
He's Uncle Tom.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to tell you why. He voted against every civil rights bill that came up before the Supreme Court. Say something, y'all. He's Uncle Tom. He voted against the John Lewis voter bill. He voted against affirmative action. He called his mother a welfare queen. She raised him. She might have been on welfare, need food stamps. Why would you call your mother a welfare queen? He talked about Obama. He married to an ugly white woman. Now, if you're going to marry somebody, at least if you're a pretty white woman, right? Get to your walk. All of our skin folks. All of our skin folks. And skin folks. Y'all got it? Let me say it again. All our skin folks. Ain't your kin folks. He made it because of affirmative action. In the 1960s, there know black people went to no white school. You weren't integrated. Came from Pinpoint, Georgia. Did he? Pinpoint, Georgia. I don't know whether we have a red light there or not, but Pinpoint, Georgia, real small. He came from Pinpoint, Georgia. Uncle Tom, Clarence Thomas. Nobody said nothing about it. Nobody said nothing about it.
Come on.
Last week, a few black men boycotted Ebenezer Baptist Church, the pastor, it was one of yours, Warnock, the senator, okay? They go and boycott his church, talking about he's not black enough. In the middle of his sermon, black men boycott his church. Uncle Tom, Clarence Thomas, you ain't boycott him. He sits on the Supreme Court.
Trump.
You ain't open your mouth about him, but you gonna ball top the senator from Georgia. He did pass a bill, let me name the bill he passed. He passed a bill to save the people some money who are diabetic, insulin.
Amen.
And all those people running voting for him. That's how he won. Saving, they don't have to pay about something like $30, whatever it costs to get the medication. Clarence Thomas ain't passed no bill. Just sit up there. Ain't cheap. And ain't nobody just scared to say something about it.
Tell it.
But moving on. Crime is so bad in Atlanta. Crime is so bad, I'll be glad to get back home. Crime is bad, they robbed, they knock you in the head. Man done worked all day long, and you knock him in the head and take his money. They're breaking your cars, if you see any valuables, a gun, a knife, or something, or whatever you got in there, they're gonna take it. They're breaking your cars in the daytime. Hijack your cars. Crime is so bad in Atlanta. They even stop, you're gonna like this one. A lot of white people got, black people got money around. They got these rich dogs, dog. And some of them $5,000, $10,000 dogs. They walking down the street with their dog. They started taking the dog. You walk down the street. You know about dogs. You know about the $5,000, $10,000 dogs. Okay, you know, I ain't know nothing about no dogs like that. All I know, if you go to the dog pile and get your dog, you need them. That's all I know. Black on black crime is so bad. Poor and black men gonna get killed today while we sit up now. Poor and black. White man ain't got nothing to do with black folks killing black folks. Poor and black men gonna get killed today.
Mercy.
Every day.
Mercy, Lord.
God send poor and black men get killed. We know that some of the white men hate us. We know that. We also hate each other. We hate each other. Where's your love? Darkness cannot drive out darkness. Hate cannot drive out hate. Only love can do that.
Yes, sir.
Dr. Martin Luther King. Only love can do that. God is love. Yes. God is love.
Amen, amen.
The United States population is about 325 million people. There are over 400 million guns. Registered guns. When you buy a gun, they register. They tell you what state you bought the gun and where you live at. 400 million guns, 325 million people. One out of every 20 gun owners have an AR-15 rifle, assault rifle. One out of every 20. It's easier to get a gun than to vote. If guns was the answer, why we have all these murders. Guns is not the answer.
Amen.
Guns is not the answer.
Amen.
We so heavenly bound sometimes. We ain't no earthly good but nobody. Nobody. Y'all remember the story of the black man selling ice and the white man selling ice? And this black man, they had little boots with his head next to each other. The black man would walk by him every day. And he said, one day he said, wonder why you go over there and buy the white man ice every day, you know, all these months, you never bought an ice for me. He said, I tell you, the white man ice is colder than your ice. Y'all get on the way home. Y'all pray for Fannie Willis. Pray for Fannie Willis. She's a prosecutor in Atlanta, trying to put Donald Trump in jail. Y'all pray for. Y'all pray for Letitia James. Got some cases up there in New York against Donald Trump. Pray for. Pray for Alvin Bragg's New York prosecutor. Got some cases against Donald Trump. I'm going to sit down with you, man. I'm going to sit down. A poor man voting for a Republican is like a chicken voting for Colonel Sanders. Right. afraid to come out there Republicans. Republicans are mean spirit people. All they think about is violence, killing folks, and telling lies along with Donald Trump. That's all they think about. Violence, want to kill you, and then they tell lies.
Mercy.
Black women, this gonna blow your mind. Black women voted only 5% for Donald Trump. Black women, thank God for our black women. What percent do you think the black men voted? Approximately 15%. 15% for Donald Trump. Thank God for our black women.
Amen.
Thank God for our black women.
Amen.
Donald Trump is a con man. He conned his way all the way up to the White House.
Amen.
Told lies. And you're going to watch him. He might be back in the White House again.
Amen.
You don't get out of the boat. Dr. King says injustice anywhere is injustice everywhere. Alexander the Great says, I can't change everything in life, but I keep trying. The steps of a good man are ordered by God. No white man has ever been charged for committing a crime against a black man in Valdosta. In other words, he never went to jail for nothing done.
Amen.
No white man has ever been charged, ironically, in Valdosta for the crimes he done against a black man. If you don't vote, don't complain.
Amen.
There are 59 black congressmen. Check this out. There are 59 black congressmen. Half of the black congressmen are women. Women, thank God for our black women.
Amen.
Half of more women.
Amen.
Where's your faith? Where's your faith? We call ourselves Christians. Where's your faith? Where's your faith? We walk by faith and not by sight. Everybody stand up, stand up, everybody, stand up. All right, sit back down. That's faith. You have faith in that chair, that chair will hold you.
Amen.
That's called sit down faith. Where's your faith? Where's your faith? Where's your faith, black man? Where's your faith? Jesus Christ said, be thou faithful to death, and I will give you a crown of life.
Yes, sir.
We serve a God that has never been indicted. We serve a God that has never been impeached.
That's
the prophet Michael said in the Old Testament, asked the question, what does God require thee, O man, to do justice, to love mercy, to walk humble with that God? That's all God requires to do. That's all we got to do. Get it? God is concerned about your education, what school you're attending. God is concerned about what kind of house you live in. God is concerned about the little penny money you got in the bank. God is concerned about what kind of car you got. Let me tell you what God is concerned about. God is concerned about, did you feed the hungry? God is concerned about, did you clothe the naked?
Yes, sir.
Did you visit the prison?
Yes, sir.
Did you take care of the poor? Did you take care of the widows?
Bring it on
in. That's what God is concerned about. That's what God is concerned about. Did you minister to our young boys and girls? That's what God is concerned about. Only what's done for Christ will last.
Yes, sir.
Thank
Amen.
You.
Amen.
Praise the Lord, saints.
Praise the Lord.
You still good, ain't
you? Yeah, all the time.
All right. I'm going to have to get the microphone. We're going to stand by. We ask you to stand. Give us a song. Something to open the door. What can make me whole again? Nothing but the blood of Jesus.
Nothing but the blood of Jesus.
God bless you and help. We're going to turn it back in the hands of Deacon Martin. Amen. That's going to give us a full sight. We love you. Hallelujah. Thank you.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning. Good morning.
It's good being in the house of the Lord. And so see so many familiar faces. Truly, we thank each and every one for coming out to help us celebrate our Men's Day program. And I learned one thing. You start calling names with a memory like mine, you'll miss somebody.
Yes, sir.
Amen. Amen. So truly, we thank everyone. The ones, the speaker especially, Deacon Willie Ray.
Amen.
I thought we together. We thank Minister Winston. And we thank the one that introduced him and all the public guests. But truly, we thank those ministers that may be in the audience. And we thank everybody. And the ones that sung the choir did a wonderful job.
Amen.
We thank those of you because we got people that travel, y'all, from 50 to 100 miles. We thank you and let you know we appreciate you coming. Amen.
Amen.
And most of all, we thank God.
Amen.
Because truly what we do, it's not about us, church. It's all about God.
Amen. Amen.
And that's what we want to do. Grand New Zion Christian Center. Lift up the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Amen. So truly we just all of you be blessed and have a safe church. And we pray for each and everybody individually and their families. Amen.
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 But we getting close to last time. God bless y'all. We want to thank everyone that came out today. Amen. We certainly needed your presence here today in our Men's Day program. But we thank God for the Master, our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Amen. For saving us. Amen. And giving us the mind to run. Let's see what the end is going to be. Amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
There's a mic.
Come on.
That mic.
Don't have to announce that.
I'm George.
Switch it on.
There you go. I'm George Foster Rhymes, and
it's on.
I'm George Foster Rhymes, to get to the Free Press social media outlet, and I've been recording like this for God knows how many years. Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, many of your social media giants, they pretty much have blocked me out. I can post videos, but they don't want y'all to know what I post. And that's what they do. Mm-hmm. But just in case God opened the door, and he does, mm-hmm. where my videos are getting out in spite of,
yes.
this video will be seen in a few days on Boston GBR YouTube channel. Just go to YouTube, and you will see this video. The reason I had to get up and say something, because as my friend and brother, Brother Rachel spoke today, I wish to God, I pray to God, that we had more ministers, more deacons, and more black men to stand up and speak
Amen.
As he just spoke today.
Amen.
I don't know if you appreciate it, but he put seeds in my garden. And I water my garden. And I know that those seeds are coming up.
Right.
You may not like them, but you will benefit from the fruits that fall from this tree
yes.
that came from the mouth of God through Brother Ray. Thank you, my pastor.
Certainly, amen. And once again, amen, that you're doing, amen, the work that God got you doing, amen. We do thank God for our speaker, Pastor Messon, amen, for coming out, amen, on this visit. Amen. I certainly appreciate y'all, amen. The reason I was born when you was talking about me in that kind of Thomas. I was just born in that year.
Okay.
Amen. 56. Amen. But God brought me a long way.
So that's right.
Amen. Amen. I thank God for it, because I had the Lord on my side, I knew I wouldn't be here.
That's right.
I'm one of them guys out of Miami, you know, and it was kind of rough down there. I've been here in New Zealand for 15 years, and I thank God for it.
Amen.
Amen. I do go visit, but I had to hurry up and get back. It's just, it's a total different world.
It is.
Amen. I thank
God for you all of you that come out, amen. We got inspiration for this message to our viewers, amen. You know, would you mind dismissing us this morning? Thank you.
Y'all know some of the stories when Moses got tired. Mm-hmm. He was winning the battle, but when his arm began to get a little low, Aaron had to lift it back up.
Yeah,
my brother asked me to lift it back up. Amen. To do this benediction. Nobody but you, Lord. Nobody but you. Nobody but you, Lord. Nobody but you. My mom used to say, when I was in trouble, you brought me over. Nobody but you, Lord. Nobody but you.
Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you for this service on today. We thank you for your visitation. Thank you for the speaker. We thank you for all of the people that came out to fellowship in this glorious occasion of means, Father God. But we stand on your word in Psalms 133, how good and how pleasant it is for brothers to dwell together in unity. Father God, for you command your blessings to be there. Father God, just anoint everyone today and give them strength and give them safety as they travel back to their home. And as we get ready to leave this place, but never your presence. Come with us to our homes and our destinations. Father God, keep us, teach us, and hold us together. Most of all, let your blood cover and keep your hedge of protection around us. Lord God, that when we hear, we grow. And when we grow, we show. And Lord God, and now show that we really know that you is in control of all things, that we keep our faith in you. Only for Christ we stand. All other grounds are sitting and saying. We thank you right now as we dismiss these people. In Jesus Christ's name, amen. Y'all may be dismissed. Amen.
We were coming up like you did, man. Satan, I come creating, penetrating with force from the land of the lost and coming.